Hello YouTube, my name is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome to a very, very special video on my channel today. Now recently, I was asked by my good friend Lord Rexasaur to take part in a tournament known as Heroes of the Old World. Now on the screen, you will see a group of four players. It is myself, it is Lorenzo von Karstein, it is Gladiator Gamer, and King of Pergamon. The four of us are in the first group. And our group is purely vampire based, so all four of us are playing as the Vampire Counts faction. We're playing online battles against each other, and how it works is, I'll put a little thing on the screen right now for you guys to see the rules. Basically how it works is, the winner of the group will go into group 1, whoever finishes second goes into group 2, whoever finishes third goes into group 3, and whoever finishes bottom of the group goes into group 4. There are three other groups as well as this one. There's four players playing as the dwarves, there's four players playing as the greenskins, and there's four players playing as the empire. And it works the same way, so after group one, group two, you'll have one of each faction, and then after that, then it'll be a knockout stage. It's quite a long tournament. It's really nice because it means you get a nice bit of grounding with the faction you've picked. I've picked the vampire counts, and what we're going to do, I've already fought these battles. I'm not going to spoil the results or anything, but I will be talking you through my replays, where I think I did well, what I think I did poorly, and how I think I can improve in the future, because I think it's a good idea to do this sort of thing. So what you'll see on the screen right now is a battle replay. This is my first battle of the group. I'm obviously, we're all the vampire counts, like I said. So this is my army by here. I went with two units of Black Knights. I went then with four units of Graveguard with some experience points. I've got two units of Crypt Ghouls in the front by here. I went with a Vampire Wizard, and I also went with Manfred on a, is that a Wing Bard, I think it is? Not quite sure what it is. I then went with Crypt Horrors by here, finishing that off then with two Vargeist units floating by here, and then in the trees by here hidden, I have two units of Hex Race. Now my opponent is Lorenzo in the first battle. And also guys, all the competitors in the group, as well as Lord Rexasaur's channel, will be in the description below. If you follow Lord Rexasaur's channel, you will see all the other groups' replays as well. It's a good place to check out the whole tournament if you want to see replays of the whole tournament. Over here then, for Lorenzo, on the left flank, he has Black Knights. He has some Crypt Horrors of his own. He has lots and lots of Graveguard. Let's have a look. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 units of Graveguard there. He also has Manfred on the Zombie Dragon, but there. And he also has a White King melee specialist, but there. As well as a Vargulf. And also hidden, he has 2 units of Black Knight. So what we're going to do is play the play button, and you'll see how the battle unfolds. And I'll talk you through it. Also, there's a timer at the top of there. 8 minutes or so this battle lasted, which is quite good for an online battle. So I started off by advancing my armies forward. If I hold on the spacebar, you'll see my movement orders by here. So I moved my Black Knights to the left flank around the rocks by here. His units were hidden. I didn't know where they were. Mine were hidden at the front there. He didn't know where they were either. I decided to be quite aggressive here and push forward, which has been one of my kind of playstyles in Warhammer thus far, being very aggressive, getting in their faces. I think it's a good strategy for the vampires. Although it can be a bit difficult against vampires, you know, yourself, but you kind of have to do it with the vampire counts because you have no ranged capability really, apart from magical spells and spellcasters, so you kind of have to do it. So I brought forward my Manfred, I brought forward my Lion Shade. I don't know what formation I was going for with the Graveguard, but here I think I messed that up a little bit there, but I'm moving things around, trying to reform them as we speak. I forgot to move my Graveguard. I think I was doing them one at a time. I completely forgot not to do them properly. Anyway, along the right-hand flank, I've taken my Vargeist right the way up around him and gone for an early flank. And I've also moved my Crypt Horrors into this right-hand channel as well. Lorenzo still hasn't moved his Black Knights yet. He still kept a very rigid formation here. Hasn't moved at all, really. He's just going to react to what I have to do. I'm also going to show you the troops I have. So I had 998. He had over 1,000. Obviously, the Graveguard gave him a few thousand more. So I moved my cavalry forward by here on the left flank. I didn't know they were hidden, so I moved them forward. I then looked to the other side of the battlefield, moving my Vargeist around. I turn around as it's too late, and he is able to get the charge into the side of one of the Black Knight's units. I am able to react to this, though. And what I'm able to do then is bring them forward, and he also has a Vargul for them, which he throws in as well for good measure. So a good little combination by Lorenzo there. He's trapped the one Black Knight unit, which is losing decisively, as you can see, and then the Vargulf going into the other Black Knight by here. I've brought my Vargeist right around the flank, able to flank him relatively easily here, and I've gone straight for his general, for his Manfred. Going to go straight in there with my Vargeist going with both of them. I've also decided to push up with my Crypt Horrors now, and while I attack the rear and the flank with the Crypt Horrors, and while he's tied up my Black Knights up here, I've decided to move my whole army forward and try and press home that advantage as I've split some of his troops up. I've still got my Hex Race, which is basically my ace up my sleeve in this battle. I've kept them hidden for quite a while. As you can see, the timer's going down, 6 minutes or so. They've been there for 2 minutes now and have not moved at all. I've kept them hidden, kept them strong and secure there until I decide the time is right. So I've brought forward my units here. As you can see, I've used Freight of Bajuna on the Grave Guard. Not a bad move to use, considering that I've thrown my Crypt Ghouls in there. Big mistake by me, but I've learned from this now. I should not have thrown Crypt Ghouls in there, because Crypt Ghouls are a good flanking unit, but not really good for the head-on charge. Better off going against sort of bigger troops, but on the flank. In a standard melee fight against Grave Guard, they're not going to win. I've decided to bring my Hex Wraith in now. Surprised him with a Hex Wraith attack. Charged them, flying in. Done really well with them. Got them flying in. Pretty decent charge into the Black Knights. And my Crypt Horror is actually starting to lose decisively now, which is not good for me, of course. You'll see that I have, well, Lorenzo has some Black Knights, which are bringing into the battle. Now he's charging them in. I've got my Vargeists all tied up on this flank. Now I've brought them from one side of the battlefield to the other. And you can see it's basically a battle going on over here, a battle in the center and a battle on the right flank. Three separate battles going on. And you can see, if you look at the balance of power, relatively close, but 100 each so far that we've both killed from each other's men. My Lord's under attack, apparently. My Lord's actually in the center by here fighting. And he's up against the White King here. I'm trying to take down the White King. Got my Hex Race. I'm pulling him back. Going to bring them back for another charge. Bring him out to go back in. My Crypt Horrors, though, have caught up with quite a few of their units here, which is in some ways is good, because pulled some of the infantry away from the main line here, but at the same time I'm sacrificing a unit, basically, and a very good unit with Crypt Horrors to try and, you know, do that. I've got units wavering over here. I've got my Black Knights wavering. They've been under a lot of intense fighting, although his Vargulf is also starting to crumble here, which is really good. Critical binding losing currently, which is really good for me. Our Vargulf is an absolute beast to take out, but if you can take it out, that's going to be obviously amazing. I've now decided to bring my Hex Race that are now reformed up. I'm going to bring them to the left flank. It looks like that's where I need them at the moment. The right flank's certainly gone. The Crypt Horrors did a decent enough job, really, but not enough that I was hoping for. And now he's able to free up his Manfred and bring him into the center. Is this a good decision? Is this a bad decision? But we'll find out in a few moments' time, guys. That massive dragon, zombie dragon by Lorenzo there, is in the center up against my legendary Manfred now, my legendary Lord. Also, I got some Graveguard in the mix there. I've brought back my Hex Rays. Going to go for another recharge there. On the left flank, though, you can see those Hex Rays definitely made the difference. I've basically turned this left flank around now. Done really well on this left flank. He's brought back some Black Knights to help countercharge here, though. So he's bringing some more troops from his right flank over to the left. Looks like that's what's happened. Once the right flank was sort of dealt with, everything just moved to the left naturally and shifted over here. We've got troops fighting over here. We've got Black Knights on Vargulf. We've got more Black Knights against Vargeists. We've got all sorts of different beasts and creatures on this left flank fighting. The center is still holding just about at the moment. We've got troops starting to crumble around the place. Got my Graveguard wavering there. We've got my Hex Racer have come into his Lorenzo's Manfred by here. Now, I'm trying to snipe his Manfred by here, basically, because I know that if he goes, it's going to be a massive demoralization for his whole army. So I've decided to move my Manfred out from that fight here and took him onto his Lorenzo, for Lorenzo's Manfred along with my Hex Race. I've got 2-1 against his Manfred by there now. Although I know I'm going to lose this line by here, because we've got too much very good Graveguard, experienced Graveguard units against mine in the center here. But the left flank's going really well, as you can see. The Vargulf is almost gone by here, fighting the Vargeists. Vargeists on Vargulf fighting by here. Who's going to win? Oh, that was a massive charge in by there, but the Vargulf looks like he's on his last leg. He's drained. The Hex Race doing really well against the Black Knights here. They've made a massive difference, the Hex Race. And as you can see, the Black Knights are starting to crumble. At the moment, it's just too close to call. I got about 300 or so left. He's got 800 or so left, but I am starting to take him down quite quickly, as you can see. It's gone quite tight. A unit's been wiped out, unfortunately, for me. You can see now, though, his Manfred is on his last legs. If I can just take him down, then we're looking pretty good in this battle so far. Lorenzo's Manfred, is he going to survive? And as you can see, he got taken down by there. And you'll see the units start to fly down now. You've got some of his units, Graveguard, wavering by there. You've got one of his units crumbling by there. But that left flank has been secured. I finally was able to secure that left flank. Able to free up my Hex Race and two Vargeist, or what's left of them at least. And now I can bring them out. As you can see, I move them straight away. I'm going to get them into that flank where it's needed, because I've got units routing, but I've got a unit of Graveguard which is routing. So I'm going to fly into that with my Hex Race to try and salvage something from this flank. We are holding on. I'm hoping that the morale will have a massive effect, and as you can see, it is having a massive effect. He's losing quite a lot of men now. Mine are starting to waver as well and crumble. You got his Crypt Horrors, which have been in the battle a long time, doing lots and lots of damage. They're starting to crumble as well. I've now pushed everything into this left flank. I'm trying to salvage his left flank by here and trying to push up into his center. Many of my troops are starting to crumble. Many of his troops are starting to crumble. At the moment, it is too close to call. My Manfred is still alive at the moment. His has been gone now for about 30 seconds or so. I'm hoping that will be enough to clinch the battle. But as you can see, the balance of power is just slightly in his favor. I only have 100 or so left. He still has 600 or so remaining. He still has all of this by here. And as you can see, most of my troops are starting to go now. My Manfred still fighting in the center here. Still holding on for dear life against these Crypt Horrors. Crypt Horrors, of course, doing lots and lots of damage. My Manfred now starting to waver. And this battle was one of the hardest battles I fought, as you can see. Balance power now definitely against me. I've only got 87 remaining, and you can see I'm starting just to try and salvage a quick smash and grab with the Hex Race. Just going to try and charge them in, trying to do some sort of damage right at the late stage. As you can see, there's 6 seconds, 5 seconds remaining, and my troops are now starting to waver. And well done to Lorenzo for the first victory for his. It's a valiant defeat, definitely a valiant defeat, and that was one of the most enjoyable and also one of the most sweaty battles I've had so far in this game. One of my most enjoyable battles as well. I'm so pleased to be able to show you that battle on my channel in the form of replay. Anyway, guys, now we'll move on to battle 2. Hello and welcome back. So this is battle 2 of the Vampire Counts group stage, and I'm up against Gladiator Gamer. Again, his link to his channel will be in the description below. And what we're going to do, we're going to show you my army so far. So this is my right flank. This is also, this is the Northern Chaos Waste battlefield, which is quite a tricky one, because you have a bit of an incline my side and a bit of an incline his side, and then you've got a massive kind of flatland at the center, almost like a race to get to the center of the battlefield. Anyway, on my right flank I have two units of Black Knights, which have two ranks of experience. On my left flank I have two units of Hex Wraiths, which have one rank of experience each. I then have two units of Vargeist, which I used in the previous battle here. I have another unit, well, I have a unit of Cairn Wraiths here, along with 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Graveguard. I also have a unit of Crypt Horrors. I have a Vampire Wizard, and I also have my Legendary Lord, which again is also on a flying mount like previously. Now, what you'll see in this, just by looking at the battlefield, if I show you the tactical map here, you'll see massive errors on my part straight away. So I got cavalry here, I got infantry here, got my beasts, my Crypt Horrors, and I've got my Vargeist at the back, and I've also got cavalry here. It's very stretched, as you can see. It's a massive gap between there and a massive gap between there. You look at his army, look how regimented his army is. He's got everything pretty close together. You'll also see he heavily outnumbers me. He's got Black Knights here. He has Skeleton Spears at the front. Lots of Graveguard, and they're the Graveguard with great weapons as well, which are going to do quite well. He has experienced Skeleton Spears. He's used them pretty well on those units. Plus, he has Black Knights there. He also has his Gladiator Gamer Wizard at the back then as well. So I'm going to play the battle. You'll see how it unfolds. I went for something a little bit different. I went for more specialized units and monstrous units in this battle, which was not the smartest thing to do, which I've learned from. I mean, you probably can guess the result from this straight away. Even just from that kind of deployment setup, you'll see that I'm at a massive disadvantage. If I just show you the balance of power, I have 818 against 1,626 troops. He doubles my unit count already. So I think I lost this battle from just the unit selection screen. It was going to be a difficult battle to fight. Gladiator Gamer is a very good player as well, to be fair to him. So that was my first mistake. My second mistake is what you see right now. I move my Hex Race up. Hex Race are a really good cavalry unit for the Vampire Counts. I bring up my forces. I'd be quite aggressive again. But I didn't realize that his general, as you can see, his wizard right by here, which I think is Manfred on a barded horse, or barded nightmare, I think. But there he is. He brings him to the right flank. I had an opportunity here with my two Hex Rays. I brought them up, and I basically just brought them up and just did not think. And then he brought him to the nearest part of my troops by here. He also brought his vampire up here. He brought his two of his specialist units plus some cav. I was obviously outnumbered, and I decided to not charge him. I just decided to go straight on ahead. I could have probably got a charge in off him or onto these by here. Instead, I want to try and flank around. I tried doing the same thing on the right flank as well, which you will see in a moment. But look at that, he's open for the charge. He's actually open for the charge. Okay, he's got Black Knights nearby, but I could charge him. And again, he's there for the taking. I just don't take it. I don't know what I was thinking there. I made a massive error, unfortunately, and you'll see in a moment my Hex Race just get dealt magical damage. They are a very expensive unit. I think they cost 1,200 as well. And look at that. That unit of Hex Race is almost dead straight away. I allowed Manfred to get an attack on him easily. And boom. That Hex Wraith is almost gone straight away, just like that. I made a massive error there. On the right flank, we have two units of Black Knights. I don't know what the hell I'm doing here. I tried to go flanking around. I was hoping to get flanked, but I didn't realize he'd have such a long line, which really stretched my army, which was already quite thin, even further. So I tried bringing them in now, trying to get a charging off them. But at this moment in time, to be honest with you, I did not know what I was going to do. I did not know how I was going to win this battle. I did use some magical spells, tried weakening some of their main line, which is a good strategy. Try weakening the Grave Guard, which you can see I have done. I also did it with this unit of Grave Guard at the center. I'm doing it again here, trying to weaken them, trying to get that force down with Fate of Perjuna, I think I used. Spirit Leech. I actually used Spirit Leech on these. Probably not the best thing to have used. Probably should have used that on Manfred himself, or the vampire wizard. But in the end, I decided to bring up my main line. I'm actually targeting all of them straight ahead, dead on. Trying to attack them dead on here. I've engaged them with my Var guys, trying to get some kills in here. I've got my Black Knights tied up with multiple units here. And this is the numbers game now. I've got 4-on-2 here on this flank. Hex Race are both gone. They've just gone completely, as you can see. Manfred, with the assistance of the Black Knights, was able to defeat them quite easily. And then I've just got a very thin line at the center here, which isn't going to do much. I mean, it'll do damage. This one's doing quite well. This unit of Grave Guard is winning against this one. This unit of Grave Guard is actually losing against this one. And this one's losing against this one. Although it says they're both losing, which is quite weird. I've used some more magical spells, Fate of Perjuna, to try and weaken them. Is it Fate of Perjuna? I think it is. Weak binding. Can't really tell. Can't remember what I used. I think it must have been Fate of Perjuna. I used up all my magic. As you can see, I've only got 2 left in the tank now. There's only about a minute or so left of the battle. As you can see, I'm down to 400 troops already, and I've taken about 300 or so of his. Which is going down quite fast. I've made a bit of a comeback, but not enough. Definitely not enough of a comeback. My Black Knight's just gone completely. My two flanks just gone, crumbled very, very easily. My line is stretched, and he's actually got a chance to go into my rear now. He's able to get his troops around those flanks, get them pile into my Grave Guard rear. They're gone completely. My general is completely up against it by here. I mean, he's doing some damage against Skeleton Spears. He's going to do well against them, but the thing is, my line is gone completely. My flanks are gone completely. He's going to bring this whole right flank forward. Get them into my flank by here against my Vargeist. I've got nothing left on the battlefield, as you can see. If I show you an overview as this is going on right now, this is what it looks like. The amount of red you'll see compared to yellow. I'm completely stretched. I've got units not near each other. This is being an absolute cock up on my part. This is like when Rome lost against Carthage at the Battle of Carrhae, where they got completely outflanked, outmaneuvered. And this is what happened here. I basically pushed forward too far. I was too stretched, got completely enveloped, and it's an absolute massacre in the end. Fair play to Gladiator Gamer. He did really, really well, fantastically well. And like I said, his channel is in the description of the video, if you wish to check that out. But my wizard's getting completely wiped out by here now. All my troops are crumbling. Only a few seconds to go, and as you can see, he's still got over 1,000 men left. I only took out about 600 or so. Which isn't very good. It says close defeat, which I think is lying. I think that was probably a comfortable win for Gladiator Gamer there. And as I bring you to the next screen, you'll see now some of the results here. I mean, my Crypt Horrors did well. 87 kills. Happy with that. But then you'll see some of my troops, like my Hex Race, were completely wasted. They were the worst unit. I did not use them at all. 7 kills and 6 kills. That is just not worth it for the price you're paying for them. I did not use them effectively at all. My Vargeist, again, you know, 55 kills for them, not too bad. 19 could be a bit better. The Black Knights did relatively well in that right flank, all things considered. And then it's a mixture then. Graveguard, 84, pretty decent. And then 23, 48, and 28. My Manfred did well, but Manfred's always going to do pretty well. He's a pretty good Lord. His Manfred didn't actually get any kills at all, although he did wipe out my Hex Race, but that doesn't register, I don't think. And then some of his units actually didn't get any kills at all, like Skeleton Spears here got wiped out almost. Well, half wiped out, but only got... didn't get any kills at all. And then some of them, like, had 6 kills, 4 kills, 8 kills. But I think it was more of a case of him outnumbering me, able to whittle me down and outflank me relatively easily. Anyway, guys, let's move on to Battle 3. Hello and welcome back. This is Battle 3 and it is fought on Glacial Lake, which is a fantastic battlefield. It's very straight, very crammed together. You've got a nice little chaos kind of thing down there with some other weird chaos insignia and stuff down there. I'm against King of Pergamon, and this is the final battle of the group after two defeats in my first two battles. So we'll start off with my left flank. We have 4 units of Black Knights. I've gone with a lot more infantry in this battle. I've gone with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units of Graveguard. I've gone with 2 units of Crypt Horrors. I've got 1 there and I've got 1 there. Heavy damage dealing Crypt Horrors. I've also got my Wizard and my Legendary Lord all together, but they're Manfred. And my, did I say Wizard? This is actually a vampire. It says Wizard on there anyway. I've also got 4 units of Skeleton Spears across the front by here. And I've also kept 1 unit of Hex Race this time, but I've put them inside here. Now he's actually gone with 4 units of Black Knights. 2 of them actually have Lances and Bardin on this left flank. He has a very long line then of, I think, a Skeleton Warrior. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units of Skeleton Warriors. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Graveguard. I think he's got a mixture of Great Weapons at the center with 2 on the flank. Also rank 3 as well on the flanks, which is really good strategy to have. He's got some Crypt Horrors behind the lines. 2 units of Vargeist, plus he has Manfred on a zombie dragon. So this is the setup for the battlefield. Let's play. About 8 minutes the battle is. So I don't charge up initially straight away. He doesn't either. I'm looking at what he's doing. I see that he's got flanks. We're actually chesting each other out. But a massive, massive error on my part in this battle. Vampires, of course, have no ranged units. He has Vargeists. And he also has a zombie dragon. I have nothing to counter this. I did not bring Vargeist this time. This is the first battle I didn't bring any Vargeists. And I also don't have a Manfred on a zombie dragon. Therefore, I have no aerial capability apart from my magic, which I'm already using right now. I'm trying to use Spirit Leech on their troops. I'm trying to weaken their Vargeist. But as you can see, I have nothing to attack them. If they're in the air, I can't attack them. Also, a flying unit, if you go behind their lines, you can actually use some sort of fear debuff. I think it decreases morale or something. I'm trying to work it out, but here it does something to them. Inspired ability, I'm trying to work it out. It's on one of these things. It shows me, I don't think it will. But anyway, he's outflanked me with these, completely just flown over my head. I got nothing to counter. I've got nothing to counter, which is really embarrassing, but it's how it is. Now he's brought up his cavalry, and I've munched them with my Hex Race. Combat's even. I probably should be bringing my Graveguard up. I think I do bring my Graveguard up. They are just waiting here at the moment, just enjoying the snow right now. I decided to bring them into the center instead, not to attack the flank there. Not much I can do there, though. Hex Race are there. They are combat even, although they are starting to waver now slightly. His Manfred got free range on my Manfred. And as you can see, he is really weak now because I can't attack his, but he can attack mine because of the whole range thing with the vampire counts. Because I had nothing to counter this, I could not do anything. All I could do was just take it. So in the end, I decided to just charge in and engage his lines. I got decent units in the front line, Skeleton Spears and Graveguard. I charged them in, but as you can see, my Manfred is going to go down very easily in this battle. Nothing to counter, and I can't do anything apart from take it like a man. And there he goes, he's down. My Manfred is dead after about 2 minutes of the battle because I had nothing to counter. And this emphasizes my point earlier in the video where I say battles can be won and lost on just the faction selection screen. Obviously, in tournaments, there's rules and restrictions of what you can bring and what you can't bring, and the amount of stuff you can bring. So battle to battle, I've been trying to learn. I do think I improved a lot by this battle. You'll see that in this battle now. I do demonstrate a good fight back here. I throw in my Black Knight here against his Skeleton Warriors, which are starting to crumble. I've got lots of units crumbling on by here. He does have... where's it by? I throw my Crypt Horrors into his line as well to try and disrupt them. He's got his own Crypt Horrors in this. We're going to have Crypt Horror on Crypt Horror action here. He actually has... it's one Crypt Horror he has there. A couple of my troops are crumbling. A couple of his are crumbling. I've sent in my Grave Guard though, and he is losing his center by here. His Skeleton Warriors are going. My Crypt Horrors doing heavy damage there. I've set my Vampire up now to try and help out. Skeleton Spears are holding, doing pretty well, although they are wavering themselves. My main line is also doing pretty well here. And at the moment, it's actually pretty even. I mean, we've got over 1,000 of each, both of us. I've actually taken out 700 of his troops compared to about 300 of mine. I've actually killed more of his than he has of me so far. So even though he's killed my Lord, which is obviously going to be a massive advantage for him, my line's held. And you can see the line's held pretty even across the battlefield. That line hasn't barely changed at all. Whereas previous battles, you've got units running around over here, over here, over here. This is just a complete line that stayed the same pretty much all the way. Although he does have King of Pergamon, has his Manfred on a Zombie Dragon, which has a massive effect. He also has some Winds of Magic he can still use, which he's using to antagonize my troops and use his debuffs on my troops there. He also still has his Vargeist, which caused me some trouble and headaches over here. This line is going pretty well for him at the moment, although I'm still holding. I got my Crypt Horrors in there, got my Grave Guard in there, and they're doing relatively well. It says they're actually winning as well. Combat even. My Crypt Horrors are winning. His troops are crumbling here though. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. About 6 of his troops are crumbling right now. And about 5 or 6 of mine are crumbling as well, all over the place. And you just don't know who's going to win at the moment. It's just a fat, massive line. You got good troops against bad on either side. I've got good troops, like I've got, for example, in the center. I've got Crypt Horrors up against his Skeleton Warriors and Black Knights. Also got my Vampire in there for a little bit of assistance. No chance there for him. But on this flank then, he's got a lot more troop advantage. He has his Crypt Horrors over here, plus his Black Knights, plus his Skeleton Warriors against my Grave Guard. Lord is dead, which isn't helping. In melee, unit losing. Losing decisively this unit of Grave Guard. And I got my Crypt Horrors also trying to help out and try and deal heavy damage as well. We've got still over, well, just under 3 minutes to go. He's bringing some troops around to this flank, trying to secure this right flank of his now. Or his left flank, my right flank rather. Although these two have done well, they've actually fought off everything that's come at them on this flank. And I can push them up now into the Skeleton Warriors here and try and get some damage done to them. Try and get them to crumble if at all possible. As his Zombie Dragon just looks on, taunting me. As he can fly in now, he can actually charge himself in there and go for a charge if he wants to as well, which he's able to do. Lines are still just about holding. If you look at the stats here, I've got about 500 left. He's got 800 left. If you look at the deployment, he had 600 troops more than me at the start of this battle. So I've done really well in this battle, all things considered, even though I lost my Lord. That's the only real mistake I made, was the fact that I had nothing to counter his aerial threat. If I did, then I think this battle could possibly go a different way. Although it's still a chance at the moment. I am losing troops very quickly, but his troops are routing as well. I'm doing heavy damage to King of Pergamon's troops here. The Black Knight losing decisively there. Those Crypt Horrors, though, are just causing me so much headaches right now. Crypt Horrors are really good. You want to get them in your army if you're a Vampire Count. They do heavy damage, especially against units like Dwarves. Very good to have. This Black Knight is almost gone, though, here, though. Got some Grave Guard and some more Grave Guard against them. He's bringing up his Grave Guard. Look at that, though. Rank 3 Grave Guard. Don't stand a chance against them. Done really well selecting them there. The lines are still going. I still have 300 or so left. He has about 600. He has doubled my troops at the moment, but you had 600 or more troops than me at the start of the battle, which is interesting. Gonna bring his legendary Lord Manfred to help out, help route off my Crypt Horrors here. My Crypt Horrors are obviously doing lots of damage in that center, being really good all battle by there, and it's going really well so far. So Grave Guard are up against Grave Guard. They are even at the moment. Well, mine's losing. It says his is losing slightly. This graveyard's almost gone. That vampire Manfred on top of the zombie dragon, though, can do so much damage. Like, you can just fly him in unopposed, completely unopposed in the air, and he can just charge in, do lots of damage, break up the system. I don't think they kill. I think they actually get back up. Yes, they do. But, of course, it's going to cause all sorts of formation disruption, which is going to be useful to him anyway. Look at that, though. That line's completely broken now, and it's just broken off into a little detachment over there. A little detachment in the middle and a detachment in the left-hand side. An interesting way to look at it. You had a massive line earlier. Now you've just got three detachments with a zombie dragon flying around, causing all sorts of mayhem. You can go from the right flank. You can now go to the left flank and help secure that as well. In the center, just go and fly in. Go and charge in. He's actually going the left flank, I think. And as you can see, my troops are almost gone, apart from my vampire, which is in the center by here, but the rest have all crumbled now. She's just about gone. And it's 500 or so troops against zero at the end. A valiant defeat, though. Did really well there. And we'll have a look at the screen. So I deployed 1,686. He deployed 2,037. I lost 1,600. I still took out 1,400 of his, which is pretty damn good, in my opinion. So my Manfred, as you can see, didn't kill anything, which is absolutely terrible. My vampire did well, though. She killed 66. My skeleton spears, 57, 69, 62, 93. That's a very good one there. Graveguard, 47, 54, 88, very good there. 87, very good there. And this, look at that, 141 killed for that Graveguard. Fantastic. And this one, 95. My Black Knights could have done a lot better. 23, 21, 37, and 48. And the Hex Rates, again, did not use them that well in this battle. Better than the last battle, but certainly not that well. 32. And then this is why you want these. Look at that Crypt Horror. 142 kills. Amazing. This one only had 42, which is quite disappointing. And if you compare that to his had 68. He had one, I had two. If I used that one a bit better, perhaps I could have turned things. Who knows? His Graveguard, 133 kills there. Very good there. I think that's the highest he had. 109 for this Vargeist. Vargeist are really useful. I wish I'd brought them in this battle. That certainly would have helped. Anyway, guys, as you can see from the replays in this video, I actually finished bottom of the group, unfortunately. But that means I now go into a brand new group in round two. And in that, I am joined by officially Devin, who is playing as the Greenskins. I'm joined by Hef, who's playing as the Dwarves. And I'm playing as Last Rebel Gaming, who is playing as the Empire. So it's us four against each other in group two. And how it works is the group winner goes through to the quarterfinals. That is how it works. So basically, group one and group two is top three in both those groups. And then group three and group four is just the group winner. And then you'll have eight players that will play at the knockout stages in about a week or so's time. Anyway, guys, I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.